Good morning. This is Wednesday morning and I am Tanuja Dabir, mind body transformation with a nutritionist helping high achieving women who are done feeling crappy take their lives back by helping you feed your body and your mind optimally so that you can have more freedom, you can have more fun, and you can reclaim your power back. And today I'm going to be talking about mindfulness. So is your mind full or are you mindful? Now, why I'm asking this is because, you know, it's the middle of the week. We are all, you know, going about doing our things. We are busy with work and there are other commitments. And basically, whether it's the middle of the week or the weekend, I find these days everybody is just stressed and on the go all the time. And that means we are doing things on an autopilot mode. We are just rushing from one thing to another, one deadline to another, one commitment to another, you know, whether it's for us, for our kids, or, you know, whoever. It's just go, go, go. And that means we start ignoring how we are feeling. We just push down our feelings and we just power through them. It means we are, like I said, on an autopilot mode, just going from one thing to another without stopping to breathe and really connect with our bodies. And you know, that's okay for a while when you have to get things done, but it's become a lifestyle these days. It's become so much of, you know, oh, I am busy and I'm stressed. It's almost like if you aren't, you start feeling guilty that you are, you know, maybe you're doing something that everybody is doing, and it makes you feel as if you're part of the crowd. So it's kind of very an odd way to look at things. And yet, you know, if you're not busy, we start feeling guilty, thinking that, wow, what am I missing on? What should I be doing what I'm not doing now? And you know, we have become human doings rather than human beings. And that's a challenge because, you know, over time, that is what leads to burnout. That's what leads us to feel exhausted and fatigued in our body. And it sometimes makes us feel resentful. It sometimes, you know, because we haven't stopped in a while to think about what is it that we really desire. Are we looking for all the materialistic things that, you know, we work towards, you know, the money and the house and the car, which are great, they are needed, you know, but have we lost ourselves somewhere in the way? And that's exactly the kind of work I'm doing with my clients, to help them reconnect and find out, because eventually, if you don't take the time to reconnect with yourself and being mindful, you do end up, you know, starting to feel lost, disconnected, you start feeling stuck. Sometimes there is anger, you know, why am I working so hard, what for? And those emotions then may start manifesting as physical symptoms. So you could be emotionally eating, you might have digestive upsets or heartburns, or you might be having insomnia, not sleeping well at night. So really the question for you today is, are you mindful or is your mind full of things, full of worries, full of to-do lists and, you know, chores and responsibilities? What is it that's going on? And really, the concept of mindfulness is not new. We all know about it. But just taking a moment in the day to reconnect with ourselves and be really present in what we are doing is important. And some of the simple things that you can do is understand that mindfulness is being, you know, moving away from being on an autopilot mode to being in a mode where you're aware of your surroundings, of what you are doing. So, you know, we are distracted these days while, you know, we are eating lunch, we're checking our emails or our phones. We might be, you know, cooking and still listening to the news or doing something else. So we're multitasking all the time, and that is quite distracting, honestly. So only if you start paying attention to what you're doing, and that is so important when it comes to eating, because, you know, I have, you know, worked with clients who want to lose weight, who want to control the amount of food that they eat. And one of the simplest ways to do that, I always tell them, is to really sit down when you're eating. Hi, thank you for the heart who joined in. I cannot see you, but I can see all the hearts, so thank you very much. So one of the things that I always tell them is that when you're eating, just sit down and eat. Hey, Lisa, it's you. Okay, I can see you now. Hi. What was I saying? Yeah, so when you're sitting down to eat, please take away all the distractions. No phone, no TV, no reading. And just sit and enjoy the process of eating. You know, smell the food. Feel the texture in your mouth. Is it soft? Is it crunchy? Is it salty? You know, get the taste, the aroma, the spices that go into it. When somebody has cooked for you, or if you've cooked for yourself, you've taken the time to prepare a meal. And you know, besides the you're guilty of this too. And yeah, we are all. I am too, right? Like, I feel that I think I'm wasting time if I'm eating and not doing anything. And it's become such a common thing these days where we feel that if you're just focusing on that one thing, then we are wasting time. We should be multitasking. It almost becomes like a given that if you're not multitasking, we are lazy, we are getting less done, we'll be left behind. And it's just a horrible feeling to be in with that rush, 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 go, go, go. So eating is one place where you can really sit down and enjoy your food. And honestly, if you're mindful about the way you eat, you will eat less. You will actually end up eating less because our brains, our brains needs 20 minutes to register that we're eating and getting full. So if you are in the middle of an email and, you know, just pushing food down your throat, probably you'll be full way faster and overeat without knowing it because your brain is just focusing on that email or on that TV show that you're watching, not figuring out that you're done eating. Another great way, I think, to get away from the autopilot to awareness mode is to really start consciously bringing yourself back to the present moment and asking yourself, what am I doing right now? So, you know, if you're watching this, is there something else going on in the background? Are you getting distracted by it, right? So even if this is like a replay, are you listening to me at the same time and doing something else? So, you know, again, I've been guilty of this. Sometimes I have somebody's live stream going on, and I might be folding clothes or doing my laundry or something else, you know, again, because I think I'm wasting time just doing my laundry, right? So why don't I listen to something? So it's just these little places where you can bring yourself back to awareness as to what you're doing. And if you aren't aware, if you're always on that autopilot mode, sometimes you figure out, you know, after the fact that you've done everything, it's like, wow, how did I get here? How did I drive to this place? Oh, I'm already done my laundry. Did I even take a shower today? It's funny, you know, in how many places we just forget we have done something because we've been on the autopilot mode. So mindfulness is really about going away from an autopilot mode to come to awareness. It's about not doing as much, but being, feeling, experiencing what's going on around you, within you as well, right? And it's also about going from the past or from the future, I'm so guilty of this all the time too, right? I really have to make a conscious effort to bring myself to here and now. I'm either thinking about, oh, all the things I have to do in the future, you know, I have to get that email out, I have to get on a call with the client, I have to prepare the recommendations, I have to cook, I have to pick up my son, I'm in the future. Or I'm thinking, oh my God, you know, I forgot to do this, and I should have done that better, and then I'm in the past. And again, I'm missing out on the present and the now, so I'm always in the worry mode, whether I'm about to thinking about the future or about the past. So it's those main three things I find that help with mindfulness: going away from autopilot, coming to awareness, getting away from just doing all the time to being, feeling, and getting away from thinking always about the past or the future to being present here and now and fully enjoying whatever you're doing. right? So it is that, and that just helps you reconnect with your bodies. Sometimes if you're stressed, you know, it'll show in your body as aches and pains, as tightness in your neck or shoulders, and that these are common things. You know, when I have some back issues and I go see a massage therapist and a physiotherapist regularly, and these are some of the things they're always saying. Most of the common complaints that they see is aches and pains in the shoulders, upper back, neck, lower back, because that's an area where we carry stress when we have responsibilities. That's how our body stores stress. So all that tightness that you might be feeling or that discomfort might be from the stress. And if just, you know, you took a few moments in the day to reconnect with your body and just sit and breathe for just a minute, not long, just 60 seconds, and, you know, take 5 deep breaths and just feel where is the stress, where is the tightness, where is the tension in your body, you will immediately recognize, oh, it's in my shoulders, or in my back, or I feel it in my bums or in my feet, and just do a little stretch for another minute. So 2 minute break, you can afford that in the day, for sure. Right? So do that for yourself and just make it a daily practice, and slowly you will start to feel more and more connected with your body. You will recognize what your body needs. You will start understanding the cues your body is giving, and that's one of the best ways to start connecting with yourself. And it's exactly the kind of things we are going to be discussing in my live workshop, which is coming up on 7th of May. It's a 2.5 hour workshop live here in Vancouver. I will post a link to it. So if you want, seats are limited. So if you want in, make sure you grab them soon. And if you are not here locally and you want to still work with me and figure out how can you connect with your body better, how can you feed and fuel and nourish your body and your mind better, reach out. I'm here to help and talk with you. Would love to do that. So I'm off now for a meeting, and I'll see you soon. Thanks for joining, Lisa. And if you have more questions, feel free to pop them up. And I'll come back and answer them. And if you're catching this on a replay, leave me a comment. I'll definitely reply back. So take care. Bye. See you soon.